Good evening. In continuation of that previous two part, so today also we are going to discuss some more important Government of India schemes related to that agriculture and allied sectors. So this current year that Government of India also presented that budget, particularly that agriculture segment is presented under theme of Aspirational India. So in this budget also some new schemes were announced. So those schemes we can discuss one by one. So the first one is Kishan Rail scheme. Actually this particular program will be implemented with the help of Indian Railways, that too through PPP mode, that is a public private partnership mode. The main objective of this particular Kishan Rail scheme is provision of refrigerated coaches in express and freight trains, mainly for the farmers to transport their perishable items like milk, meat and fish. So this is a really useful scheme as far as that the farmers is concerned. So if these kind of facilities are available, the farmers, they can transfer their perishable items from one place to another place without much losses. So that is the advantage of this particular scheme, that is a Kishan Rail scheme. In line with Kishan Rail scheme, another scheme, that is a Krishi Udan. So this is also that declared in during this current financial year budget. So on the previous scheme, that Rail, so in the Kishan Udan scheme, they are going to have a similar kind of facilities in the aeroplanes. So this scheme also implemented with the help of the Ministry of Civil Aviation. So here also they are going to have a cold supply chain facilities for transfer of the milk, meat and fish in the aircraft. So this will be useful for the farmers for quick transfer of the perishable items from one place to another place. So by that way the farmers will get more income, and that whatever that materials are produced without much wastage, that will be utilized. So third scheme, this scheme also announced this current year budget. So that is a Thane Lakshmi Village Storage Scheme. So actually this scheme is a supportive scheme. Already we have one scheme, that is a Pradhan Mantri Kishan Sampad Yojana, that is a PMKSY. That particular schemes mainly aim for holistic development in the food processing. So for processing of the food items, we need raw material like grain or seeds. So all those things need to be stored before those materials are processed. So for storage of that grains or seed material, and this particular scheme need up more hands and also more storage facilities. So in order to fulfill this particular PMKSY requirement, this particular scheme was announced. So under Thane Lakshmi Village Storage Scheme, and the self-help group and the women self-help group will be given with loan under Mudra schemes for the purpose of creation of that storage facilities at rural level for the purpose of storing the seed and grain material. So this will be a useful one. So this will be prevent that post-harvest loss, particularly that storage loss and all. And then another scheme, so this is floated in the year 2016, that is a SAMAN. So that is a coordinated horticulture assessment and management using geoinformatics. So with the help of that geoinformatics, it is planned to assess the horticulture crops. Then based on that assessment data, they will go for the management. By that way, they are looking for that improving the protection potential of the horticulture crops. So this particular scheme is conceived by the Department of Agriculture and Cooperation and Family Welfare under the Mission of Integrated Development of the Horticulture, initiated during the year September 2014 and collected as Chaman. So for this purpose, they are going to avail the facilities available in the Magalonopis National Crop Forecast Center in collaboration with ISRO and Department of Space Centers. So all those centers jointly work together in order to fulfill or realize the objective of this particular scheme. So this particular scheme is Chaman, related to horticulture. So under this scheme, they are going to assess the horticulture crop growth and all with the help of the geoinformatics. So based on that assessment, they are going for the management of the horticulture crops. So in order to fulfill these objectives, that Department of Agriculture and Cooperation Family Welfare, they are going to get the help of the Magadan Office, National Forecast, Crop Forecast Center, and ISRO and other centers of horticultures. Then FASL scheme, FASAL scheme, so forecasting agricultural output using space, agrometeorological and land-based observations plotted during the year 2010. So again, this one also based on the satellite data. So they are going to have a satellite data and real field data. With the help of that, they are going to collect the or call out the economic related informations. So this program also sponsored by the Ministry of Agriculture. Here also that ISRO and state remote sensing application centers, state agriculture universities and any other institutions related to that agriculture, jointly they are going to work together. So that is a FASAL scheme, that is a forecasting agricultural output using space, agrometeorological and land-based observations. Then another scheme, that is a National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture, that is a NMSEA, started the year 2014. Under NMSEA, some subcomponents also there. So those subcomponents are rainfed area development, ROD, soil health management SHM, submission on agroforestry, climate change and sustainable agriculture, monitoring, modeling and networking, like four different subcomponents are there under National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture. And also these have five major objectives. The first objective is to make agriculture more productive and sustainable and remunerative and climate resilient by following that integrated farming or composite farming systems. And the second one is to adapt comprehensive soil health management practices. Third one is to develop the capacity of the farmers and stakeholders, because now that the changing climate is trending. So in order to mitigate the negative effect of that climate change, what are the things we have to do in agriculture? For that purpose, that farmers knowledge should be improved. And the fourth objective is to conserve the natural resources, particularly that soil and water. And fifth one is to optimize utilization of water resources, that is bringing more crop per drop of water. So these are all the things with reference to National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture. And then another scheme, National Mission on Micro Irrigations. This scheme was announced during 2010. Actually, this scheme was existed previously in the name of Micro Irrigation Scheme. But during the year June 2010, the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs approved implementation of that micro irrigation scheme as a national mission on micro irrigations. During 11th plan period also, around 8032.90 crores was allotted. Out of 8032.90 crores, 3409.26 crores will be contributed by the Department of Agriculture and Cooperation as a central SAR, comprising a 40% subsidy for general farmers and 50% subsidy for small and marginal farmers. So here under NMMI scheme, 40% subsidy for general farmers and 50% subsidy for small and marginal farmers are they are giving. And bringing a green revolution to Eastern India, this also a region specific scheme, mainly to overcome the hurdles faced by the rice growing farmers of the eastern part of the country, particularly the states like Assam, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Odisha, Eastern Uttar Pradesh, and that is a Purvanchal and West Bengal. So mainly to overcome that particular problem, this particular scheme was floated. This program also a part of RKVY project, that is a Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana project. The main objective of this particular scheme is making that eastern farmers to adapt the latest crop production technologies with reference to rice cultivation, and bringing more of the fallow land for under rice cultivation. By that way, that cropping intensity and income of the farmers will be increased, and create water harvesting facilities and efficient utilization of the water potential, and provision of that post-harvest facilities and marketing support. So these are all the various objectives of this particular scheme. So this scheme is mainly to overcome the hurdles faced by the rice growing farmers of the East in India. So that we are completing almost all the major central sector scheme with reference to agriculture and horticulture sites. In upcoming classes, we are going to discuss that economic matter related to that agriculture. Thank you.